Hey, MJ, what is a trap?
What's a snake trap, bro? Cause I got snakes, but they're not trapped.
Hey, MJ, what's a trap? What is that?
So, I know about, like, people trapping in the streets. I know about trap music. What's your trap, dude?
Uncle Mikey, what's the snake trap?
Well, we're in the California prison, right? Y'all see. But we got a motherfucking question. MJ, what's a snake trap, homie?
What is the trap? I really need to know, bro.
Hey, viejo, what's a snake trap?
Please do me a favor and tell me, what is a snake trap?
Yo, MJ, what's a snake trap?
Hey, MJ, what's a trap?
Hey, MJ, what's a snake trap?
Hey, MJ, what's a trap?
Hey, MJ, what's a snake trap?
MJ, tell these people about the snake trap life.
Hey, MJ, I got a quick question. What's a snake trap?
I just gotta ask you one question, man. What's a trap?
Hey, MJ, what's a trap?
My scrub here wants to know.
Hey, MJ, what's a snake trap?
What is a trap?
Hey, MJ, what's a snake trap?
Hey, MJ, it's Forrest. Hey, me and Kilo were wondering, what exactly is the trap?
Hey, MJ, what's a snake trap?
Somebody asked me, what is a snake trap? You know what? I gotta ask my man, MJ, what is a snake trap?
A snake trap? What is that?
Okay, MJ, what in the world is a trap? Let me know, man.
What's up, MJ? So I've gotta ask, what exactly is a trap?
Hey, MJ, so what's a snake trap?
So, MJ, you know, I'm over here thinking, you know, hanging out with my dog, and, you know, it really dawned on me, what's a snake trap?
All right, Tony, so I would have to say the question has been, what is a snake trap?
Well, what is a snake trap, Mikey?
Huh? Bless your trap. Love her, bless your trap. Love her, bless your trap. Bless your trap. Love her, bless your trap. Love her, bless your trap.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to the very, very first episode of the Snake Trap Sessions. I'm your host, MJ.
Tony Pythons, at your service.
And we're going to go ahead and simply discuss today, what is a snake trap? Obviously, Tony doesn't know what a snake trap is, which really confuses me. I'm scared to even ask what my fiance knows what a snake trap is. I don't think she knows, so basically, let's just start from the ground up, okay? Tony, go ahead and Google snake trap session, or a snake trap for me, okay?
Okay, let's see.
So we're going to Google snake trap. That way we're just all on the same page here.
It's right here, man. There's okay. The definition right there. Snake trap.
Snake trap. A building where snake breeders and snake enthusiasts buy, sell, produce, and simply enjoy exotic animals.
That must be this building we're in right now.
We're in it.
Yo, some people got good friends at night, I live my life right. Intense. On the edge, on the wire. I'm from the group where friction leads to fire. Stack your bricks, the time is take your pick. Do it, don't. The track, alchemist. Yo, my life is good, I got my peeps in the mix, so.
Words come to words, my peoples come first.
I got worldwide family all over the earth. And I worry about them all for whatever it's worth. From the birth to the hearse, through streets the guns burst. Words I disperse are here to free minds. Yeah. And if mine are needy, I need to feed mine.
When words come to words.
Set up shop and write a verse. Actually, what? That's best come to best. My lyrics take care of me, they therapy, get shit off my chest. Extra stress. 3-4 over the score. Different patterns of rhyming prepare me for war. So next time you see us, we'll be deadly on tour. When
words come to words, my peoples come first.
Basically, we just want to kind of, you know, express our love for these animals and then show you, you know, different species we work with and then what the future holds for the trap. Because I'll tell you right now, guys, the good thing about this channel is, you know, not only are we sharing animals, but we're going to be sharing our knowledge as far as how to do it yourself stuff. If it's how to build a rack, how to apply heat tape to a rack, simple how to, you know, make enclosures out of, you know, Sterilite tubs just like this, how you could actually go in your backyard, you know, and actually get sticks straight from your tree. I mean, there's different ways that you could do to kind of create your own kind of hubsery or enclosures for your snakes.
I think that's the most important part of this channel for me is
helping other people that are just starting out. Like when I was just starting out, it was so hard for me to figure out temperatures and enclosures and just like, what the heck am I doing? Where do I start? Where can I find all this information?
Right.
And to have this one spot where I could just go and be like, that's what I gotta do. That's how I do it. And just have it all laid out for me. I'm mostly just doing it at home, just for fun, to have a couple snakes around. So it's super helpful to have all that laid out for you and really be able to have that knowledge.
Now we know.
And knowing is half the battle.
And most importantly, it's all about having fun, you know, like even when times are getting rough, I mean, you got to look at the brighter side of things and, you know, not really beat yourself up over mistakes. You just learn from them and take it day by day. You know, I've been told that by multiple breeders that you can never know what to expect when keeping animals. You know, you just always got to keep your mind open and not, obviously not beat yourself up over little small mistakes that could happen in your snake room or snake trap or whatever it is that you call your room. We're going to have a recurring segment called Snake Trap Horror Stories. We've got plenty of horror stories that we've lived through. You know, guilty as charged with the horror stories. Yeah. We're definitely going to be showing some mishaps that had happened here at the trap and how we recovered off of it. And, you know, some have good happy endings, some don't have happy endings. But, you know, the way I look at it, the more knowledge I could go ahead and share with you guys, the more you could expect when keeping animals. Because, you know, you could do all the research in the world, but if you don't have the hands-on experience and if you don't have those actual horror stories happen to you yourself, you'll never really gain from it. You'll never really kind of progress into being a snake collector, a snake breeder, or just owning snakes in general. You get your wins with your losses. So the more losses you take, the more wins you create. We don't have any snake poop to pick up on this session. One thing you're gonna see a lot of on the snake trap sessions is snake poop. The grunt work. We're gonna be picking up snake poop. We're gonna be showing you that snake poop. It is not pretty, and you're gonna probably go to bed very disturbed with the amount of snake poop that you've seen after watching our video. If it's wet, you bet it's gonna be dirty.
Wow.
But there's also ways of picking up wet poos. I have some techniques of mine. It's called, gloves. It's, you know, what you want to do.
I usually just throw away the entire melamine enclosure after they poop and just buy a new one.
I actually have a good friend of mine, Andrew Avacedo, AA Exotics. I guess what he does is he picks up the poo with his actual fingers.
Ugh.
And then the poo goes into the fingernails, and I guess it helps the male get attracted to the female when it comes to breeding.
You're shitting.
He recommends you don't wear gloves. Pick up that poo, and you know, like the little white hard poos that get in the corner, just use your fingernails to dig that out. And the good thing about that, when you get the male and put him into the female's enclosure, it actually gets him horny. Or aroused, excuse me. But the poo and the nails...
I can't embrace that statement. I cannot
reach out to Andrew at AA Exotics. I'll put his description stuff below. Hey. He knows his stuff when it comes to breeding, and I'm pretty sure the poo in the nails is pretty key.
And that's a perfect example of people doing their own thing. Everybody has their own way of doing it. Does that make him an expert about snake poop, possibly?
If you bite your nails pretty bad, you probably should do it. That way you don't bite your nails.
Abort that idea immediately if you're a nail biter.
Abort! Abort! Abort!
Also, if you're a snake biter, get the heck off of our channel right now.
Definitely going to go over some techniques on how to keep and breed rodents, because I feel like having a good food source is very important to a good nutritious diet for your snakes.
Mikey, actually, I've never seen anyone do this, and here's another technique that I think is unique to you, and that's pretty amazing. He actually cuddles with each rat at least 30 seconds to a minute, each individual rat, before feeding his snakes. So the rat gets a little cuddle, feels super nice, and just feels proud and safe, and then they're fed to the snake. And I believe that ups their protein levels, it makes the snakes happier.
Correct. So really, if I eat a burrito, helpful. If I have enough grease on me or enough food grease to spread onto the animal, it's just going to make your snake beefier. It's science. But yeah, guys, so basically, if you enjoy the content that we're putting out, I mean, it would mean a lot to us if you like the video. But not only like it, share it to your friends, share it to your family members. Anybody you feel that would gain anything off this, go ahead and let them know that we're doing this. Spread the word. Because we will be giving back to you guys, most importantly. 500 subscriber, we will be giving away a snake. Yep, I said it. I said at one point I would never give away anything. But you know what, guys? I'm in a different ballgame now, so I definitely want to go ahead and spread the love. We will be giving a snake giveaway at the 500th subscriber.
That's pretty awesome. Okay. And 1,000th subscriber, we're going to give Mikey away to somebody for a full week and keep him at your house.
That's all. I hope your insurance covers that kind of liability.
Bless your truck, love her, bless your truck, love her, bless your truck, bless your truck, love her, bless your truck, love her, bless your truck, bless your truck, love her, bless your truck, love her, bless your truck, bless your truck, love her, bless your truck, love her, bless your truck.
We could get into it, boy. What you waiting for?